My dear devotees, we will now, in 12 minutes or so, start the 24-hour kirtan, which is called in Sanskrit Akanda Kirtan, uninterrupted kirtan for one whole day. In the scriptures, this uninterrupted kirtan is also called Anam Yakya, a yakya or sacrifice where the main item which is offered to the Lord is the holy name, Naam Yajna, or Sankirtan Yajna. So, we all know that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has introduced this style of Gaudiya Kirtan, and he has also given indications how this kirtan should be done and brought to perfection. And I thought I would speak today a little bit about this question. How can we chant properly? How can we chant in a way to attract and also realize Krishna in his most merciful form, the holy name? Well, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, first of all, we should chant in a particular state of mind, which is called Dainya. Dainya is translated as something like humility. It's a feeling that even though you have different qualities which may be noteworthy, you still feel yourself as worthless. You may have this feeling of humility because you feel, I'm still so far away from Krishna. Yes, there are so many qualities which I have, but I have not corrected the main problem, that is to be separated from Krishna. Dainya, the feelings of humility, in other words, rise from a feeling that I have not reached the perfection, but in fact I'm lacking. I'm severely lacking in the association of the Lord. The followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have expressed this longing mood, this crying mood, this yearning in kirtan with some examples. They have given the example of the chatak bird. It's a bird which you find only in India, who drinks exclusively the water from the rain cloud. It will not drink any water which has touched the earth and assembled in puddles or rivers. No, the chatak bird will always fly to the rain cloud and drink the water from there, even though the rain cloud, listen to this, is not very charitable. It may withhold the water, it may thunder, it may throw flashes and lightning on the poor little beep, 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 chatak bird. But the chatak bird has this vow, I don't touch anything from the ground. So a devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doesn't seek gratification in worldly things, but he goes only to Krishna, even if he finds that Krishna is a little tough. Even if he finds in his chanting, Krishna does not respond and chooses to be a little bit in the distance, the devotee will keep on trying. Peep, 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 or Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And in this way, he earns the right to take a bath in what is called Naam Rasa, the happiness of the holy name, which descends from the rain cloud of Ganasyam Krishna, of Krishna who is blackish like the newly rain cloud. there's another mood which is very similar to this humble longing for Krishna. This longing which arises from the feeling I have not reached the perfection. I need to cry for the mercy. It is the mood of surrender. I like to tell this story until my tongue falls out of the mouth. I have said it so often, but I want to say it today again to tune all of us in. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has asked the question, whose prayer does Krishna hear? Now usually people would say everyone's prayer. Krishna has his ears and eyes and legs everywhere. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Krishna hears only the prayers of someone who surrenders to him, who gives himself over to Krishna. Then Krishna hears and fulfills the prayers. He hears everyone's prayer, but he hears and fulfills only the prayers of a surrendered soul. And the example which is given is Draupadi. Draupadi had a very intimate relationship with Krishna. Once Krishna visited her husbands, the Pandavas, in Hastinapur, and Draupadi was serving Krishna a plate of fruits. Draupadi would not allow any maidservant to serve her lord. She would do all the menial services herself. Now this fruit was a sitaphal, which tastes best if you cut it quickly and then immediately take it and taste it. So Draupadi served this plate of sitaphal fruits together with a knife so that Krishna could cut the fruit himself. And Krishna took the knife, looked in his way, you know, like his sidelong glances to Draupadi, took the knife and cut himself so that blood was coming out. Which is unusual, because when Krishna was attacked by the arrows of the enemies in the Kurukshetra battle, the arrows went right through him, because he has a spiritual body. You can't shoot light in the rays of the sun with arrows, it just goes through. So, but in this pastime, Krishna's finger was bleeding, and he turned to Draupadi, and Draupadi immediately took her royal sari. It was a masterful sari. No one of you, my dear girls, has such a valuable sari. You have 5 rupee saris. Draupadi had gold and silver in her sari. So she immediately took her valuable sari and just went like and gave some piece of cloth so that Krishna could quickly bandage his finger. Krishna looked at Draupadi, the tears of love in his eyes, and he said, my dear Draupadi, for this gift of a sari, I will repay you in millions of saris. Do you know what was in Krishna's mind? As we all know, the time came when there was this game of dice, whereby cheating methods, Yudhishthira was cheated by Duryodhana and his clique, led by Shakuni, the evil prankster, out of his kingdom. Finally, he lost Draupadi as the last wager. So when this was, when Draupadi was lost, Dushasan, like a tiger, takes a helpless prey, pulled her into the assembly. Draupadi was in her days, she had her moon phase, where the woman's mind is very much under the influence of Vata and very vulnerable. So he didn't care for this. He just pulled her into the public assembly right in the midst of these lusty Kauravas and started to disrobe her. At the beginning, Draupadi protested. She turned to Bhishma and all the Kuru elders, asking them for help. But they looked the other way. Then finally, Draupadi took her own hands. She was a Kshatriya lady, trying to protect her honor, but she lost out to Dushana. Finally, when Draupadi saw no other way to protect herself, when she gave up, she put her life into Krishna's hand, put her hands out and shouted, "Hey Govinda!"
Yeah, Govinda!
Much louder she chanted, "Hey Gopal!
Hey Gopal!
Oh Damodar!
Oh
Damodar!
Oh
Damodar!
Oh Damodar!"
At that time, Krishna, who saw the surrendered mood of his devotee, supplied her with unending sari material. He kept his word, which he gave earlier in Hastinapur, where he said, "Draupadi, for your gift of a sari, which you gave me to Bandarashmi, I will repay you in millions of saris." Krishna gave these saris, and the saris finally filled up the whole palace until everyone choked from all the sari material. Later, Draupadi asked Krishna, "My dear Krishna, you have saved me, but why did you come so late? Only in the last minute, when they almost were successful in disrobing me, then you came and saved my honor." Krishna said, "Listen very carefully, Draupadi. I came so late because only at the very last moment you had surrendered. Earlier you looked for shelter in Bhishma, in the Kuru elders, and when you saw they wouldn't protect you, then you took shelter in your own strengths and hands." And finally, only you surrendered and called it, "Govinda!
Gopal!"
And then I came and protected you. So I wish all of you that today in the kirtan, you will enter this mood, the mood of humility, knowing that nothing else will help you, mood of sincere longing, and the mood of taking shelter. And in this way, make your 24-hour kirtans successful. Two little announcements. First announcement, this kirtan is lovingly dedicated to the sacred memory of Aindra Prabhu, to whom all of us owe a deep debt of gratitude, a loving gratitude, which we will try to repay bits by bits by bits by singing nicely. And there is a second announcement. Yes, those who intend to play musical instruments, welcome, but please make sure that you know to play the instruments. If you don't know so well, let others play or don't play. Yes. We will help you with sufficient glances. When you get a glance which has a little fiery temperature, you know it is. You can play the instruments when it's very fast, then you can play it. All right.